Once upon a time, long long ago, it was believed, by the inhabitants of the Earth, that the Earth was the center of our solar system, and the sun, moon, stars, and planets, revolved around us. It was not until knowledge was increased, with new technology, that that belief was changed, and the actual truth came to be known. Now we know, it is the sun that is the center of the solar system, and we revolve around it. Do you know, that Jesus, coming as the Messiah, could not have come, before he did, because crucifixion, was not being practiced. And for the same reason, he could not have come, after he did, because crucifixion isn't being practiced. When God created the heavens, and the earth, he commanded the stars saying, "When my son is on the cross, I want you to be in this position, at this time, and for this amount of time." And he said to the earth, "When my son is on the cross, I want you to quake, at this time, and for a certain amount of time." God orchestrates his creation, with precision timing. He gave them all their information at the time of their creation, and set them in motion to perform it. Therefore, things have their appointed times, which also means things change. Therefore, things can be unknown at a current position, and at a future position be known. God gave to Israel 7 feast days, of which only one is directed by a sign in the stars. The Feast of Trumpets is begun by the sighting of the first slither of a new moon. Once the crescent moon is observed, the blowing of trumpets will commence for 2 days. Among other things, the Feast of Trumpets commemorates the Day of Resurrection and the Day of Judgment. Therefore, this day is known to be the day where a resurrection takes place, and a day where judgment will begin. No other feast has these two aspects. Because of the mysterious nature of that day, it was known to Israel as, "No one knows the day nor the hour," and "the thief in the night." When these expressions are used in Scripture, it is not saying you cannot know the day, but rather it is pointing to the very day the event will take place, and that being one day on the Feast of Trumpets. Jesus said,
"But of that day and that hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels which are in heaven, neither the Son, but the Father."
Here Jesus is saying, the event will occur on a Feast of Trumpets, but only the Father knows which one. There was a fake letter, said to be written by Paul, sent to the Church of Thessalonica. It said that the persecution they were experiencing was because they were living in the day of the Lord. This confused them, because they had been taught by Paul that they would be removed before then. When Paul heard of this, he sent them a letter saying,
"But of the times and seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. For you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say, Peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape."
Paul is saying, "Brothers, I do not need to go back and teach you again about the times and seasons, which are feast days. You keep them, you observe them, and you know their meaning. You know that the day of the Lord comes as a thief in the night, that is to say, on a Feast of Trumpets. Therefore, you know that you are not in that day, as it comes with sudden destruction." Paul further identifies that day with the travail of a woman with child. Not only is that day on a Feast of Trumpets, but it also has something to do with the travail of a woman with child. I believe that God is giving us the actual date of the rapture and the beginning of sudden destruction, once the date of the travailing woman with child is figured out. It was after Paul's death that John the Apostle gave us that date, saying,
"And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. And she, being with child, cried, travailing in birth and pained to be delivered. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and 7 crowns upon his heads. And his tail drew the 3rd part of the stars of heaven, and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born. And she brought forth a man-child, who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up unto God and to his throne."
The words, "caught up," is speaking of the rapture, and is being done so, in connection with the travailing woman with a man-child. Today, due to increased knowledge, new technologies, and the revelation of God, the travailing woman, with a man-child, seen throughout Scripture, in both the Old and New Testaments, has been identified as a sign in heaven. This was not known in the Old Testament, nor in Jesus' day. Now this riddle has been opened to us. Due to the detailed description of this event, and with modern technologies, we have come to know this to be speaking of 2 constellations in heaven, the woman Virgo, and Leo the lion, and the planet Jupiter. We have found that the alignment of these stars, exactly according to Scripture, will take place on September 23, 2017. Jesus said,
"For the day shall come upon thee that thine enemies shall cast a trench about thee, and compass thee round, and keep thee in on every side, and shalt lay thee even with the ground, and thy children within thee, and they shall not leave in thee one stone upon another, because thou knewest not the time of thy visitation."
Here Jesus is saying, "I came, and I warned you about Roman troops encamped in Israel, telling you to flee into the mountains. And those that did were saved, and those that did not, were surrounded by these armies, and the city, and them were all destroyed." Likewise, this Revelation 12 sign is a visitation of God to Israel and the church. It is an appointment God is having with his body and bride. And all those who are aware, and watching, and keeping the appointment will be rescued. But those who do not believe this is a visitation, will miss it, and go into destruction. In the beginning, it has been established that the day of the rapture will occur on a day of the Feast of Trumpets. There is no mystery here. But, no one knew what year, in which that day would take place. Now, with this alignment of the stars, I believe God is giving to us the day and year that the rapture will indeed take place. Brothers and sisters, time is short, and the rapture is at hand. Continue watching for the blessed hope, as it will keep you purified, even as you are pure. To those who have not come to Jesus, he says, "Come. Confess him with your mouth as Lord, believe in your heart that he died, was buried, and rose on the 3rd day, and you shall be saved. Know this, if I am wrong about that day, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than when we first believed. Don't be left behind.